Hello everyone, this is Revan from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 264. India's antitrust agency suspended Amazon.com's 2019 deal with Future Group on Friday, potentially denting the US e-commerce giant attempts to block the sale of Future retail assets to the Indian market leader. The regulator ruled that the US company had surpassed information while seeking regulatory approval on an investment into Indian retailer Future Group 2 years ago. Reliance Jio, Airtel, Vodafone Idea recently increased their prepaid plans in the country by up to 25%. There is a WhatsApp message circulating on the internet that appeals to users to switch off their mobile for 4 hours today. The appeal is against the telecom companies for the recent recharge hike. The Reserve Bank of India's plan to move towards the card tokenization is likely to hit a wide range of companies, from major e-commerce firms and food delivery firms to lenders, while increasing the use of cash. RBI issued guidelines in March 2020 saying that merchants will not be able to save card information on their website to boost data security. And it issued fresh guidelines in September 2021, giving companies until the end of the year to comply with the regulation and offering them to the option to tokenize. MediaTek Dimensity 8000 chipset will probably be announced early next year. The Redmi K50 series is also expected to launch in Feb 2022. The Realme GT Neo 3 will be a successor to the hugely popular Realme GT Neo 2. The brands like Xiaomi and Realme are also expected to launch new smartphones with the flagship MediaTek chipset, such as the MediaTek Dimensity 9000 and upcoming Dimensity 8000 chipset. MediaTek has been making strides in developing chips for devices other than smartphones, recently announcing its companion series of processor for Chromebooks and Pentaho 2000 chip for high-end 8K 120Hz TVs. While most of its revenue continues to come from processor for smartphones, and MediaTek has revealed that it will be launching its first 5G millimeter wave mobile processor next year. It will be paired with a Wi-Fi 7 solution and also set to be launched early next year. And MediaTek hopes that this will be achieving 10-20% of revenue growth, which although is lower than 2021 growth, is still quite decent. EU Soul has been launched in India at an introductory price of more than Rs 1 lakh. The electric scooter is loaded with a dual lithium ferrocious phosphate batteries, GPS navigation, USB port and IoT functions and many more. The EU Soul offers up to 120 km range on a single charge. MediaTek has been hyping up its latest flagship chipset, the Dimensity 9000, recently benchmarking its latest Snapdragon 8 Gen 1, and it is benchmarking its AI-related task. It definitely looks like a head-on competitor with the Qualcomm's latest and greatest, and phone makers have noticed too. The smartphone makers like Oppo, Redmi, Vivo and Honor all confirmed that they are working on handset incorporating with the Dimensity 9000. The Lava Tab with the model number 9032X receives the Indian BIS certification. Realme announced the Android 12-based Realme UI 3.0 Early Access program for the GT Neo 2. And now it's time for the Realme 8 Pro to get a taste of the company's new custom Android skin. We can expect 4 Xiaomi or Redmi smartphones which are going to launch in the early next year, which are undergoing certification process in India. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.